remember, whatever we learn today, 80% of it we forget tomorrow. It is for normal person. If we are normal, whatever we learn today, whatever we try to remember today, 80% of it is gone. And this is a natural process. Our brain is taking a lot of information now. This fan is making some sound. There are visual things that are coming to you. You are looking at me. There are some things here, some things there. Some sounds are coming to you. Some thoughts are coming in your mind. Something is going on in your stomach. Something is going here. So there is circulation, digestion, nervous impulses. Okay? A lot of information coming to the brain. So the brain has to decide what to keep and what to throw out. What to remember and what to forget. So the best thing or the best approach is, suppose the brain feels that a particular thing is important, keep it. Whatever is not important, forget it. Now how does the brain decide that something is important and something is not important? Suppose you start learning Kepler's law today and you revise tomorrow and day after tomorrow. What will happen? The brain will come to know that Kepler's law are something which are important. And hence, brain will make a certain effort to remember Kepler's law. Okay? Now, remembering names. How to remember names? I have already told this to my old students. If you remember, you tell. How to remember new things or names? Can you tell? Okay, make a story. Now suppose I asked some names. Sushankita, no? Yes. Akshada, Nidhi. Now Sushankita is difficult for me to remember. So what I can do is, I can link this name to something which I already know. Okay? Sushant. So I have heard this name, Sushant. Sushankita. Now Nidhi. I asked the meaning of this word Nidhi. So the meaning will help me to remember the name. Okay? Raj Lakshmi. So it is the name of goddess. Lakshmi goddess, Raj Lakshmi. Raj related to king or royalty. Okay? So like that. Sharvari. I don't know the meaning of Sharvari. What is the meaning?
Early morning.
So whenever I want to remember Sharvari's name, I will think of something which I already know so that I can remember her name. Rishikesh is the name of a place. Rishikesh. Prayag, Rishikesh. These are names of places. Rishikesh is a holy place. People go there and do lot of puja and all. Okay? So Rishikesh I can remember. Guru Raj. So Guru Raj is what? Yes, Guru. Teacher. Raj. Guru Raj, that means many teachers are there and he is the best among them. He is the Raja. He is Guru Raj. Something like that. So, you can make a story, you can add meaning to it, you can remember names. Okay? Samyak Darshan, Samyak Acharan. That means right knowledge, right way of thinking, right way of acting, all those things. Samyak. So, that will help me to remember his name. Okay, Tejas. Tejas means what? Lot of light. Tej, light. Okay, so Tejas. So, this will help us to remember the names. Attach meaning to the name. Try to find out the meaning to the name. Try to make a story. Try to attach something which you already know so that you can remember things. Understood? Yes. So, who would like to tell Newton's law? One more time. Yes.
Newton said that every object in the universe attracts another object due to gravity, and he showed that
whenever you are talking, you have to be very clear with what you are saying.
Newton said that
we know that you know English.
Yes, sir. Newton said that every object in the universe attracts another object due to gravity force. This force is directly proportional to the programmable masses and inversely proportional to the distance between
square of the distance. Square of the distance. Yes, so yesterday. Yes.
The force between two objects is directly proportional to the product of the masses of the two objects and it is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the two objects.
Yes, before that you have to mention that every object attracts every other object. So you said that the force between two objects, which force? Which force are you talking about? There are many types of forces. So mention that force of attraction. Force of attraction, or you can say force of gravitation. So force of gravitation is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. This way you can tell. You have to specify what you are talking about. There are different types of forces, remember. Yes. So yesterday we saw the Newton's law, and we also saw what is the effect of mass and distance. So if the objects are close enough, the force of gravity will be very high, and if they are far apart, the force will be very less. When they are separated by infinite distance, then it will become zero. So gravity never becomes zero. So we are away from the sun. Suppose we are in space and away from the sun. Sun is going to attract us with a non-zero gravitational force. Non-zero, it is not zero. Of course, it may be very less if you are far away from the sun, but it is attracting. Moreover, if we are in our galaxy, other galaxies also attracting us, but the force is very less, so we are not going towards that galaxy, because our galaxy is massive, our star is massive and very close to us. Other galaxies are also bigger, but they are far apart, and hence we cannot see the effect, but it is there. Remember, it is there. Gravity never becomes zero. It is always there, very less, but it is there. So gravity acts over infinite distance, very large distance. The sun is attracting me, other galaxy is also attracting me, cluster of other galaxies are also attracting me. So it is over a very large distance. So yesterday we also saw the derivation and how Newton came to know that the force is the inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the planets and all those things we saw. We also saw the value of small g. Small g is the acceleration due to gravity. Small g is the acceleration due to gravity. Change in velocity with time. As the object is falling, the velocity goes on increasing. The velocity is maximum when it touches the ground. When it just going to touch the ground, the velocity is maximum. Whenever we throw an object, the velocity goes on decreasing. At one point it stops and then it comes down. If the initial velocity is more than 11.2 kilometers per second, the object will escape the Earth's gravitational force and will go away from the Earth into the space. We all saw these things. We also saw that the value of G changes from equator to pole. At equator, the Earth is bulging out. At pole, it is little bit flattened. And hence the value is different. The value is also sum. Now let us go ahead. Yes?
Also, when the astronauts go in space, they are given the training in zero gravity. How does that work?
Now, we cannot stimulate zero gravity. Remember. So the word zero gravity itself is wrong. I told you that gravity will become zero at infinite distance. Gravity is there, but it has very less value. Now, if astronauts are to be trained, where to train them? We are on the earth, so we cannot stimulate zero gravity condition or so-called zero gravity condition, which is there in space. Gravity is less, but how to do that? You can do the preliminary exercise in water. Water buoyancy is there, no? Your weight becomes less. You feel that your weight becomes less in water. So with the suit is very heavy. That suit you have to put on and go into water and do the things. Okay? And there are other machines also which whirl you very fast so that you will get the feeling of sitting in the rocket. When you are in the rocket, you are going against the gravity at a very high speed. So all the organs and the blood come down. And very few people can survive it without training. Normal people, if they go, they will die. But astronauts are given special training. So there are machines which will whirl you around, and in water you can do other things. He is saying that if we have an air current, very strong air current, then also you will feel weightless. But actually you are not weightless, because the air is pushing you up, you feel that you are weightless. But there are things which you can do. Direct exercise we cannot do, we cannot stimulate that condition here. You have to go to space only. But there is a lot of things, exercise and all those things are there. With the help of that, astronauts are trained to do what they do in space. Understood? Any other question? Now, with depth, we have seen the value of G reduces. As you go down, the value of G reduces. At the center of the Earth, it becomes zero. Now, mass and weight. Mass is the amount of matter present in the object. Mass never changes. It is the constant quantity. It's the amount of matter that is present. Never changes. You are on Earth or on Mars, it will not change. SI unit is kg, mass is a scalar quantity, it is same everywhere, its value does not change even on other planet. According to Newton's law, it is the measure of inertia of an object. Now you might be knowing what is inertia. Yesterday I told you that if a bus is there and you try to push it, it has more inertia, so it is very difficult to move it. But if a cycle is there, you can easily push it, because it has less mass, less inertia. So every object tries to be in its state of rest. If you try to push it, it will resist the change in its state. So inertia is related to mass. Mass never changes, it is constant everywhere in the universe. Amount of matter related to inertia, remember. Weight of an object is defined as a force with which Earth attracts the object. So if F is the force, weight is equal to F is equal to mg, where m is the mass and g is the gravitational acceleration. So it is, its unit is Newton. So it is a vector quantity, it is directed towards the center of the Earth. As the value of g is not same everywhere, weight of object changes from place to place. So this we discussed yesterday, that Samvik was saying that if I go to moon, what will happen? My weight is 36 kg, and if I go to moon, what will happen to my weight? It will be 1/6 divided by 6. So because of the gravitational acceleration, because of the gravity force that is acting on us, we feel our weight. So weight is different, mass is different. Mass is measured in kilo, weight is measured in Newton, remember. So in everyday life, yesterday we said that in everyday language we say kilo, but actually mass is measured in kilo and the weight is measured in Newton. Go to the next page. Now gravitational waves. Now first of all, we have to understand what is a wave. Wave is a disturbance created. Wave is a disturbance created in a medium. For example, water, and you throw a stone over a still water surface, what will happen? Yes.
Ripples formed.
Yes, ripples are formed. Yes? Anything else?
It's state changes.
Yes, state changes. State changes means what? The particles are there, they were still.
They set in motion.
They are set in motion. Which type of motion is there? Yes? Up and down motion. Particles were at the surface. They move up and down. Remember, they do not travel with the wave. Particles never travel with the wave. I am not talking of sea waves. Sea waves, the water is coming towards you. I am not talking of that. Still water is there. You throw a stone, there are ripples created, there are waves created. Water is not going there. Waves are going there. Means what? Energy is transferred. Energy is transferred. You are disturbing the water, no? So that is creating ripples, and the particles are going up and down. You can do a simple experiment at home. Take a bucket full of water, make small pieces of paper and just place it over the surface, and take an object like eraser or pencil and drop it into the bucket. What will you see? You will see the ripples created. The bits of paper will not move with the wave, but they will move up and down. So this is how waves act. Now, gravitational waves means what? So this is a concept which is beyond our curriculum, but they have introduced and told us to read about it. Little bit they have told us. And here we enter into the Einstein's theories. We are not going ahead because limitation of time, limitation of our syllabus. But a brief introduction. We have three dimensions. If you look at the corner, here we have vertical, this way and this way. We are three dimension. Any object can have length, breadth, height. Length, breadth, height. These are called as three dimensions. Now time is considered to be the fourth dimension. Okay? Now let us see simple example. Suppose this is a two dimensional board and there is an object in it. If you are looking from the third dimension, that is outside the board, you can see this circle. But when you are looking from this frame of reference, when you are seeing inside through this, you will not see circle. You will see like this. You cannot see circle. You are inside, no? You have only two dimensions. You can have length, you can have breadth. Okay? You cannot see the height. So what will you see this as? You will see this like this. When the circle is coming towards you, it will increase, and when it is going away, it will decrease. It will look like this and then like this. How will you see the triangle? It will also be like this. How will you see any shape? All shapes will be like this. You cannot imagine triangle and circle in two dimensions. Okay? Now, we are in third dimension and fourth dimension is time. We cannot imagine fourth dimension because we are living in three dimensions. Okay? Now, Einstein and other scientists, they were thinking of space-time. Space-time. We cannot imagine space-time again and again, I'm telling you. But to give an analogy, space-time is considered to be a fabric. Fabric.
Like in the days.
Yes. Suppose a fabric is there. Kapda. Fabric. And we have three dimensions in it and fourth dimension is time. If an object is present in it, it is going to distort the fabric of space-time. Suppose a very big star is there, it is going to change. Suppose this is the space-time fabric and a star is there. So it is going to change the fabric, it is going to distort the fabric. Something is going to happen here. There will be changes in the continuum of the space-time. Okay? Now, suppose there is a black hole. Black hole means what? A place where all directions are toward one place. That is somewhere, we don't know. We cannot imagine. We don't know, we cannot imagine that. Because we cannot imagine space-time. So forget about black hole, we cannot imagine. So there is some place where infinite density is there, very large density is there. After the death of star, when the star has finished its fuel, that is hydrogen, it compresses, most of the atom is empty space. You can compress it to very high degree. So very small mass will have very large mass. Sorry, very small volume will have very large mass. So something like 1 teaspoon of black hole mass will weigh very, very, very large, something like Earth. The whole Earth can be fitted into a very small, tiny part. Very small, tiny part. So that is where, what black hole is. So no matter where you go, you end up only one direction. Okay, so you go from here, you come from here, you come from here, you come from there, you go there only. Only one direction. There is no escape. That is black. Now there are different black holes. And suppose two black holes come together, they circle each other. And there is change in the space-time continuum, there is reflection, there is ripples created into space-time, and those ripples, they travel and those two black holes merge, and there is sudden burst of energy, and that energy was detected by LIGO. So they are given the full form, laser interferometric gravitational wave observatory. So it is a 4 kilometer by 4 kilometer, like this. 4 kilometers here and 4 kilometers here. Two lasers are there. Okay, not two. One laser is there and one laser is reflected two times. So there is one mirror here, another mirror here. don't worry, these things are not there for your exams. Okay? Just for your understanding, it will not come in exam. Don't worry. So suppose there is a laser here, very powerful laser, 1 megawatt, very very powerful and uniform, only one wavelength. And the wave comes here after reflection, here there is a mirror, reflection it comes here, again it comes here, and then there is change in the wavelength. And that change is very 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 tiny. And that tiny change they have measured, many of the scientists do not believe what they have done. Half, more than half of the people, they are saying that whatever they are doing or whatever they have done, they are not believing it. Because what you are doing? You are taking a very large distance, a very 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 large distance, and you are telling very small changes taken place. How small? Smaller than the hair. Smaller than the hair. And distance is how much? Very very large, very large, lakhs of kilometer. If you consider lakhs of kilometer and they, this much change is there, what happened? So they have said that there is a change in wavelength of this laser, and that change was because of the change in the space-time fabric that was caused because of the merge of two black holes, which created gravitational waves. Okay, so LIGO has detected it, and many other things are coming now, but few people accept this. Many people say that we don't know.
So they have sure. the music, the one second music of the detection.
Huh?
They have recorded the music, the original.
Yeah, the sound. That sound. Came
see,
from the life
of see. Remember, whatever you are saying, now you do not understand. See, sound is requiring medium. We are talking of light. Light does not create sound. Light and sound are different things. Okay? They are telling you for your understanding. It is beyond your understanding. That's why they are saying music and all those things. It's not related. Not related at all. Light and sound, what you are saying. We have heard it and we have recorded and all. You are not understanding anything. That's why you are saying. And they are not understanding anything. So they are saying. What they will tell you, no. You people do not know anything, you do not know science. What we will tell you? We have heard the sound, we have heard the music of gravitational waves. This is what media tells you. But media people do not understand. They make it such that people will get something from it. Okay, so if you go to the videos, yesterday only I saw the video about this. So they say that it's very difficult to say what we are doing and measure what we are doing. And there are two of such laboratories separated by distance, and whatever change they are measuring is very tiny, little change here and there. That might be an error, maybe. Okay, yes.
So like in the newspaper it had come that there were these three scientists who got the Nobel Prize. Astrophysics and last year only, I guess, for detecting the sound of the Big Bang that the Big Bang had created.
Sound?
And they said it sounded like a bird's chirp.
Yes, we'll discuss that. But that Big Bang is over, or where was it? Collect more information about Big Bang. Page, where is it? It was there or somewhere? Okay, let us go ahead now, free fall. We will discuss about Big Bang later on. Now let us start with free fall. There are many things to be discussed before that, and then you will understand what is Big Bang. One of you just who said that you like Big Bang? You said no. So you gather information about it and you come here and tell. Okay? When will you do that? Tomorrow. Right. So let us start with free fall now. Yes, somebody read. Yes.
Sir, in the question?
No.
We know that the force of gravity due to the earth acts on each and every object. When we were holding the stone in our hand, the stone was experiencing this force, but it was balanced by a force that we were applying on it in the opposite direction. As a result, the stone remained at rest. Once we release the stone from our hands, the only force that acts on it is the gravitational force of the earth, and the stone falls down under its influence. Whenever an object moves under the influence of the force of gravity alone, it is said to be falling freely.
Underline. Whenever an object is under the influence of only gravity, then it is said to be falling freely. Continue.
Thus the released stone is in a free fall. In free fall, the initial velocity of the object is zero and goes on increasing due to the acceleration due to gravity of the earth. During free fall, the frictional force due to air opposes the motion of the object, and a buoyant force also acts on the object.
Yes, so they are saying that suppose an object is falling under the influence of gravity, what is happening? Object is falling, so its velocity goes on increasing. Also, there is air resistance. Air is pushing it upwards. This is called as buoyant force. Air is pushing it upwards, and this is called as buoyant force. So birds use this buoyant force to fly. So birds flap their wings. What they are doing? They are pushing the air down. So there is a pressure difference created. Because of the pressure difference, they can get a lift and they go into the air. Okay? So buoyant force is upward force. Things are coming down and air is pushing it up. Okay? So because of buoyant force, the velocity decreases. So if we have a feather and we release it, what will happen? It will slowly come down. That is because of the buoyant force, the air resistance. Air is pushing it up. And the mass of the feather is very less and the area is large, and therefore what happens? It doesn't come directly down. It floats a little bit and then comes down. Same way is the principle for aeroplane. If aeroplane engine, if you put it off at a great height, it will not fall like this. It will slowly come down, isn't it? Because it is having large surface area, the air is pushing it upwards and you can balance it. Have you heard of glider?
Yes.
So glider does not have engine.
Sir?
Yes.
Glider.
Yes.